Ladies and gentlemen, the Railroad Hour. And here comes our star-studded show train. Tonight, the Association of American Railroads presents the great Cole Porter Moss Hart musical hit, Jubilee, starring Gordon McRae and his guest star, Dorothy Kirsten. Our script is by Lawrence and Lee. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, and our music is prepared and conducted by Carmen Dragon. Yes, tonight another great musical success is brought to you transcribed by the American Railroads, the same railroads that bring you most of the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the fuel you burn, and all the other things you use in your daily life. And now, here is our star, Gordon McRae.
Ah, thank you, Marvin Miller, and a good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You know, when you go to the theater to see a Cole Porter show, why...
It's just one of those nights... Just one of those fabulous flights, a trip to the moon on gossamer wings, just one of those things.
The show is Jubilee. Dorothy Kirsten is the princess, and I am her brother, the prince. So strap on your gossamer wings, we're off on a fabulous flight to a fabulous kingdom.
How dull it is to be a king.
And a queen.
And if you think it's any fun being a prince...
Or a princess.
You're sadly mistaken.
Dull, 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 dull.
Mom, if we could do anything we pleased, what would you do?
Well, I'd sit in the movies all day, watching Charlie Rausmiller.
Hmm? Who's he?
Oh, the famous swimmer who went into the films. Mowgli. Me save girl from elephants, me Mowgli. Ah, 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 ah.
Really, Mother?
That's romance.
What would you do, Pop?
I'd do magical tricks all day long. First of all, I'd make myself disappear from this dreary castle because it's dull.
Dull, 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 dull.
You know what I'd do? I'd sweep Karen O'Kane off her beautiful feet. That's what I'd do.
Who's she?
That wonderful dancer at the Club Martinique who does the Beguine. What would you do, Diana?
I'd stop being a princess and start running after the most glamorous man in the world, Eric Dare.
Oh, and isn't he that playwright?
What a playwright, Mother. And a composer and an actor. I'm going to ditch this princess business and be a stage door Jane. Why not?
Why shouldn't I take a chance when romance passes by? Why shouldn't I know of love? Why wait around when each age has a sage who has
shouldn't all of us?
Run off.
Well, we're forgetting this is Jubilee year. I guess we have duties.
Duties be hanged, Mother. Why, do you know what they're planning for us as a special treat? The changing of the guard.
Special treat? Why, I see that every day. Might as well give me the king for a special treat. Dull, 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 dull.
Let's all go have some fun. We could all call ourselves something romantic, like Smith.
And go out on the town.
Why, sure. Father could be Mr. Smith. Mother, you could be Mrs. Smith.
Now, wait a minute. If we're going on a tear, I don't want a dull name like Mrs. Smith.
What name would you like, Mother?
Miss Smith.
Gentlemen of the captain, the royal family has disappeared. Our country faces a crisis. A royal jubilee coming up and no royalty. Call out the army, the navy, the air force, the boy scouts. Search every magic store for the king, every stage door for the princess, every movie theater for the queen, and fire that dreadful Cafe Martinique for the prince.
Ah, welcome to the Cafe Martinique, Mr. Smith. Nice to have you here again, every evening.
Good evening, Francois. Good evening.
You are just in time. Miss Karen O'Kane is about to go out. Listen.
Good evening, all you dear, dear, dear people. We offer a prize tonight to anyone in this room, male, female, man or woman, who does the begin the best. How about it?
I'll try it. If you'll be my partner, Miss O'Kane.
Oh, we have an entry. And what is your name, young man?
Smith. Your hand, please, Miss O'Kane. If you don't mind dancing with an amateur.
You're no amateur, Mr.
The sound of music so tender. It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. I'm with you once more under the stars. And down by the shore was playing, and even the palms seem to be swaying when they begin the beginning. Oh, to live it again is past all endeavor, except when that tune clutches my heart, and there we are, swearing to love forever, and promising never, or never to part. One moment's divine, one rapture serene, till clouds came along to disperse the joys we had tasted. And now when I hear people curse the chance that was wasted, I know but too well what they mean. So don't let them begin the beginning. Let the love once a fire remain an ember. Oh, let it sleep like the dead desire I only remember when they begin the begin. Oh, yes, let them begin the begin. Whisper to me darling, I love you, and we suddenly know what heaven we're in when they begin the
been all my life. I've been having such a dull time up until now.
You too? Well, it's going to be fun, fun, fun from now on.
You know, I wouldn't be a bit surprised. What are you thinking of?
Oh, I was wondering if my sister is having as much fun as I am.
I think it's superb the romantic way we two met,
Miss
Smith. Now, I want to know all about you. Who you are, where you came from, are you happy, are you in love? No nonsense now. I want to know everything.
Why, that's a speech from your play, The Silver Trap, Mr. Dare.
Isn't it, though? Tell me all.
Well, at the moment, I'm superbly happy. And also, just at the moment, I'm a little in love, I think.
But love doesn't belong in a dingy pub like this, alongside a stage door. Love needs a proper setting, the deck of a ship, a windblown hill.
I know that speech. It's from your play, The Apex.
You're quite mistaken. You don't think I just go around quoting speeches from an old play of mine?
What's it from, then?
My new play.
I think the lines I like best are from the song you wrote for your first operetta. Do you remember it?
Every word.
With that last line.
How would you change it?
Well, I would sing it this way.
Come, I'm going to take you to the biggest masquerade ball of the year. Everybody who's anybody will be there.
If you're there, that's all I care. Mother, is that you behind the mask?
Oh, shh, don't tell anybody.
I'm here with Eric Dare, Mother. Imagine. Who's your date?
Oh, you'll never believe this. But it's Mowgli in person.
And Karen O'Kane brought the prince.
Well, his family must have mounted police blood. We get our man.
And how about Father?
He's having the time of his life working magic tricks. Isn't it fun being people?
Ladies and gentlemen, I have an important announcement.
Ooh. It's that old bore, the Prime Minister.
We have the most terrible news. The royal family has disappeared. Oh. Be calm, everybody. I have reason to believe that the royal family is in this room, and we demand that they step forward and unmask themselves.
Why, we'll do nothing of the kind.
Oh. Your Majesty, ladies and gentlemen, the Queen.
Oh, foof.
The King.
Fiddlesticks.
The Prince and the Princess.
This is it, dear. No more fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, I place you all upon your honor not to reveal what has happened here tonight. Remember, the king can do no wrong.
And the whole trouble is the queen can't either.
I
didn't realize you were a princess, Diana. Miss Smith, your highness.
I guess this is goodbye, Eric.
Well, Karen, every merry-go-round has to stop sometime, I guess.
So it's goodbye, dear, and amen.
He's hoping we'll meet now and then.
It was great fun, but it was just one of those things.
We'll return for the second act of Jubilee in just a moment. Thanksgiving Day, with roast turkey, cranberry sauce, and pumpkin pie, and with the pause it gives us to return thanks for the many blessings we enjoy, is a uniquely American holiday. Although peoples in many lands and for thousands of years have celebrated the completion of a successful harvest, nowhere has the season of Thanksgiving become so rooted in tradition and gained such deep meaning as here in the United States. For to the Plymouth colonists, a successful crop after a difficult year meant much more than mere survival. It meant that the tiny foothold in their search for religious and political freedom in America had been made more secure. In the more than 300 years since that first Thanksgiving Day, American agriculture and industry have grown and prospered in this spirit of freedom. And with our unparalleled productive power, a wilderness which was able to support only scattered Indian tribes has become the home of 150 million persons who produce more, live better, and enjoy more freedom than any other people on earth. Essential to our production, to our daily lives, and to the defense of our freedom are our railroads, carrying the bulk of the products of farm, forest, factory, and mine, moving more tons of freight, more miles between cities than all other forms of transportation combined. For in America, with its great distances and vast production, only railroads can and do provide the truly all-season, all-commodity, low-cost transportation service that is so necessary. Just as the railroads bring us most of the things we need and use every day, so too will they bring the many things we will enjoy on this Thanksgiving Day. And now here is Act Two of Jubilee, starring Gordon MacRae as the prince and Dorothy Kirsten as the princess.
What a vast, nasty castle this is.
Well, you can say that again.
Well, we might all go down and see if the tulips have come up.
Oh, what fun. Oh, do let's go down and see if the tulips have come up. Doesn't it sound jolly?
Ripping. And tomorrow we can go down and look at the petunias.
Oh, I'm so sick of it.
Oh, let's face it, Diana. Our lives are dreary beyond words.
Dull.
But it's worse now. It's much worse. We've had a taste of something real for the first time in our lives.
Mama, was it like this when you were young?
Well, this is probably hard to believe, but your father was romantic on occasion.
On occasion? Why, Marie, please.
There was a song that came out the year we were married. About another Marie, probably a serving maid. And all the old Oompapa German bands used to play it.
Oh, I can still hear it.
Yes, it was our favorite song. Children sing it for us. You ought to know it. I rocked you to sleep with it.
Mama, your highness, you kept us awake with it.
You ought to see little me and Marie by the old seaside.
By the ocean we sat and we pet and we picked till we get swept out to the side.
You may have been to and had both of your eyes open wide. But you ought to see me and Marie by the old seaside.
You ought to see little me and Marie by the old seaside. By the ocean we sat and we pet and we pet till we get swept up by the tide.
You may have been to Paris and had both of your eyes opened wide.
But you ought to see me and Marie by the old seaside.
Oh, that's wonderful. Hank, do you think we could revive it for the Jubilee?
Yeah, maybe.
And do you realize that the Jubilee's tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Why, it seems like yesterday.
It seems like yesterday. Children, I'm going to take your father for a little walk. He needs airing. Come along, Hank.
Oh, dear.
Same here.
At least they had some romance in those days.
And we never will.
And I'll never see him again, Jimmy.
I wish I could do something to help you, Diana. Gosh, I wish I could do something to help me.
We've both got to smile, a royal smile, and say, it was just one of those things.
Just one of those crazy flings.
One of those that now and then rings.
Just one of those things.
It was just one of those nights.
Just one of those fabulous flights.
A trip to the moon and gossamer wings.
Just one of those things.
Started painting the town.
We'd have been aware that our love affair was too hot now to cool down. So goodbye, dear, and amen.
Here's hoping we meet now and then.
It was great.
Nothing to do, dear brother, but polish up our coronets and get ready for the Jubilee.
Hip, hip, hooray.
We hereby declare that it is Jubilee time.
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hank, you look wonderful.
So do you, Marie.
Jimmy, your coronet's on crooked.
Yes, Mother.
And now, here is His Majesty's list of Jubilee honors. Eric Nair, our most illustrious playwright, a knighthood.
Oh, good. Rise, Eric.
Charles Rouse Miller, it is Her Majesty's pleasure to create for you the office of Commissioner of Aquatics. And Karen O'Kane, you are made part of the royal household with title of Commissioner of the Royal Dance. And now, ladies and gentlemen, His Majesty, the King.
Loyal subjects, my message for this Jubilee year is, do it now. When there's life to be lived, fun to be had, live it, have it. That's why we've made all these fun people part of our royal household. Children, explain what I mean while I show everybody my latest magic trick.
Sure, Pop.
Why wait around when each age has a sage who has found that upon this earth love is all that is really worth thinking of?
See here, that an ordinary piece of string. Now watch it closely, and you will see me, by a simple flick of the wrist, turn it into a sailor's knot. One, two, three.
Well. Just plain string. Nothing seems to have happened.
Oh, yes, Father, a lot has happened.
It certainly has. Why don't we all dance?
But the trick, it's a very good trick. Now just watch.
I think we better dance.
Oh, all right. Everybody dance. This is a royal order. Let them begin the begin.
Oh, yes, let them begin the begin.
Oh, Karen.
Oh, Mr. Smith.
And we suddenly know.
And we suddenly know.
What heaven we're in.
What heaven we're in.
When they begin the begin. When they begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, lovely Dorothy Kearson will be back in just a moment. And meanwhile, thanks to our cast, B. Benaderet, Joseph Kearns, Carlton Young, Janet Waldo, Ted Osborne, Marvin Miller, and our entire company. Jubilee, with words and music by Cole Porter and book by Moss Hart, was dramatized for the Railroad Hour by Lawrence and Lee.
The Railroad Hour is brought to you each week at this time by the American Railroads. Today, we take for granted the division of the United States into four standard time zones. But once, there were almost as many different times in America as there were communities. This confusion, in which no one knew what time it really was, ended on November 18th, just 68 years ago, when railroads standardized time to bring order to their schedules. 35 years later, Congress made the new time system official by legislation. Standardization of time by railroads is just one of the ways your railroads have helped in building a nation where more people enjoy more of the good things of life than anywhere else on earth.
Oh, what a lovely princess you were, Dorothy.
And you were a prince of a prince, Gordon. Only, the next time, do I have to be your sister?
Well, I'll tell you, Dorothy, we can do better than that next Monday. We'll spend the whole half hour singing Kiss Me Again, and doing it occasionally.
Mademoiselle Modiste.
Oui, oui. Bonsoir, Dorothy.
Bonsoir.
All aboard.
Well, it looks as though we're ready to pull out. And so until next week, and Victor Herbert's Mademoiselle Modiste, this is Gordon MacRae saying goodbye.
Jubilee was transcribed in Hollywood and presented by special arrangement with Tams Whitmark Music Library. Gordon MacRae can be seen in Warner Brothers' Starlift. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, and our music is prepared and conducted by Carmen Dragon. This is Marvin Miller saying goodbye until next week for the American Railroads. Now stay tuned for your Monday night of music on NBC.
Hear the voice of Firestone with Jussi Björling on NBC.